global.asax form and its usage in our real-time web application development. In this session, we will know about what is the usage of global.asax page in our web application and where to use, how we need to use and all. In ASP.NET application, sometimes require a file direct access internally from anywhere to anywhere as application tool in secure way. For the purpose, this global.asax file is introduced in ASP.NET web application. Using this file, we can prepare events on application level and initiate the or request itself to do automation of a form of the file execution in application level without event rising from the end user. How beautiful it is. As of you know that by submitting a button or selecting of the drop down, by action of the mouse click or keyboard click to raise an events of the web form. The basic idea. And without having interaction of the person, we need to execute a form itself on scheduled time wise. We need to raise an event. How it is possible? Yes, it is possible by using global.asax form. And it's very simple, I can say that. I have implemented in a real-time scenario that the automation form where I need to schedule a job to every 15 minutes, it should identify whether data is available or not. If data is not available, it will be reflect to the end user where he is through sending a message. You are not interacted and you are not submitted the data accurately in the time being. Like a bank files and sensitive information or the cash collection from the counter. If he is not entered the collected information at the counter somewhere, I need updated information at intervals. I need not to go to the monitor, keep on updating and keep on informing him to update his information. It's not like that. System will initiate automatically and it will give an information to the user, respected correspondent user, to alert it. And also we can generate an alerts once the user whenever he is not available. Likewise, such the information we can create by using the global.asax in application level. In details, the global.asax file, also known as the ASP.NET application file, is an optional file that contains code for corresponding to application level and session level events raised by ASP.NET or by HTTP modules which are created. The application of global.asax file resides in the root directory of the ASP.NET, and runtime global.asax file is parsed and compiled into dynamically generated .NET framework classes derived from the HTTP application base class. ASP.NET is configured to so that any direct URL request from the global.asax file is automatically rejected. External users cannot download or view this code written on this global.asax file. It won't be displayed and it won't be available like XML, HTML. Likewise, pages, it won't be available at end users like a browser's place. Like globalization of ASP.NET. Here the sample global.asax file is here for your reference, which is we can generate by using ASP.NET application. I'll show you at once if it is completed the install information. And see here, the structure of the ASP.NET application file is .c# run at server, application state start. Void application start. Once the application is initiated, we need to run the code appropriately. Here are the statements. And application end, once the application is end, what to be done to be close all the things of based on the application end. Like you know that some of the users are some of the users creating sessions and they are not properly closing. Likewise, sessions if any, we can terminate from here itself. And application errors if any, we can handle from here itself. And session start, what it should be right beginning from the session for, and it's required for globalization. And session end, what are the session end parameters where we need to require to write. And note, this session end event is raised only when the session state is mode is set to inpro on the web.config. The session mode is set to state server. Or SQL server, the event is not raised. Likewise, we will see an example of global.aspx file by adding how to add global.aspx file into our project of ASP.NET. Go to the Solution Explorer and right click here and add new item of the project which you have selected. And now you will be find here that global.asax file, that global application file, application class. Once you have selected global application class, you will see that global.asax. Add to your root folder. We can call it as, this is the root folder we are adding, the file is here. Now what we have discussed till now, see here, application start, application end, code runs here, application error, application session start. Likewise, this is the information what we have discussed till now. In addition to that, you want to create and you want to initiate any application level methods, you can invoke here while executing the application. And invoke the class files of the CS files, and you straight away pass the parameter methods from here to that direct method of .cs. Globally, you can access any CS from here. And now we will discuss some information of useful information over here. The following few of the application level events, like application start, that event occurs when the application user visits a page of the application. And application session, application end, event occurs when there are no more users of the application. Application begin request occurs at the beginning of the each request of the server. And end request occurs at the end of the each request of the server. Session start event occurs when every time when a new user or user visits the web application. And session end occurs when the user stop requesting pages and their session timeout. Independently on every user request and every user and every application request, we can handle independently by using this application global.axx file globally. These are the advantages. If you want to establish a session user-wise with the logging of your own pages, you are wish to use, or else globally if you are using a common parameters, you need not to write again same things on another user or another mode, role wise user or something other forms. Straight away from the session, if it is initiated here, you will use the same parameter for all the global, all the users of the application interactions, all the irrespective of the forms, we can use event from the same thing. That's the usage of global.asax form is available in our root level of ASPX application, web application development. Thank you for watching this session. If any clarifications, get back us to write us in a comment. We will get back to you with the help of the information to help you to move ahead with the real-time examples, so on. Thank you for watching this session. Thank you.